In this example, we want to convert the point given in polar coordinates to rectangular or Cartesian coordinates. Let's start by identifying this point using polar coordinates. Remember, there's an infinite number of ways to identify this point using polar coordinates. Let's go ahead and use a positive value for r, so r will be 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's let theta be the least positive angle that has a terminal side that would pass through the given point. So this would be 150 degrees. Now that we have r and theta, we can determine x using the equation x equals r cosine theta, and we can determine y using the equation y equals r sine theta. So it's a pretty straightforward process once we have r and theta. X equals 4 times cosine 150 degrees, and y equals 4 times sine 150 degrees. Now, if we ignore the scaling on this graph for a moment, we can go ahead and sketch our reference triangle right here to determine these function values. So here's our reference triangle in the second quadrant. So this leg would be 1, the hypotenuse would be 2, and the other leg would be negative square root 3 because we're in the second quadrant. So cosine of 150 degrees is going to be negative square root 3 over 2. So we'll have 4 over 1 times negative square root 3 over 2. This simplifies. So the x coordinate would be negative 2 square root 3. And then for y, sine 150 degrees is going to be equal to 1 half. Well, 4 times 1 half is equal to 2. So the rectangular coordinates for this point would be negative 2 square root 3 comma 2. Let's go and take a look at a second example. Again, we'll start by determining one possible ordered pair using polar coordinates. Let's keep r positive, so r is going to be equal to 1. So the terminal side of theta must pass through this point. So it looks like we could use 315 degrees or negative 45 degrees. Let's go ahead and use negative 45 degrees this time. Now I can use these two formulas to determine x and y for the rectangular coordinates. So we have x equals r times cosine theta, or 1 times cosine negative 45 degrees. And y is going to be equal to 1 times sine negative 45 degrees. So again, let's go ahead and sketch our reference triangle here on this graph, even though it won't be to scale. We would label this side 1, this side negative 1, and the hypotenuse square root 2. So this would be our reference angle. So the cosine of negative 45 degrees is going to be 1 over square root 2, which will rationalize to square root 2 over 2. So we have x equals 1 times square root 2 over 2, which is just square root 2 over 2. And then for y, we're going to have 1 times the sine of negative 45 degrees, which is going to be negative 1 divided by square root 2, or 1 times negative square root 2 over 2, which of course is just negative square root 2 over 2. So this blue point here, expressed in rectangular or Cartesian coordinates, would be square root 2 over 2, comma, negative square root 2 over 2. I hope this was helpful.